Thank you. the honest relationship between two human beings. Its success is seen in that it has the largest of all memberships. Marriage begins with God. It is sanctioned by the Word of God, and it finds its root in the will of God. No man can give a step-by-step blueprint for success in marriage. To some extent, each successful marriage has its own individual blueprint. Marriage consists not in two people looking constantly into each other's eyes, but in two people standing shoulder to shoulder and facing in the same direction, giving a balance to the marriage relationship. Marriage calls for major adjustments in habits, in personalities. No two individuals are entirely unselfish. If Christ is at the center of the home, He will be drawn to bring these two partners together. And as each gets closer to Christ, each will get closer to each other. If husband and wife are to give their best to each other in marriage, they must first of all give their best to Christ in the home and in the church. We have met on this solemn occasion for the purpose of uniting this man and this woman in marriage. You know, of course, that we cannot do that by ourselves. When the Bible says, "What therefore God has joined together, let no man put asunder," it implies marriage is something in which has a part to do with God. Now that we stand here before God and in the presence of these witnesses, let us realize that this couple is about to enter not into a merely human contract, but into a relationship which is sanctioned by the Bible, proved to be valuable in human history, and is in line with our deepest understanding of human personality and human need. In the Bible it says, "A man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife." The same is true of the wife. This means that both the bride and the groom are attaching themselves to each other with a depth that will be stronger than all other ties, and if necessary, will prelude all other relationships. These two are building a new home, making their relationship primary, and no one denies this understanding of the Christian concept of marriage. To Amanda and Russell, cannot enter into a sound marriage. Let him speak now or forever hold his peace. We are gathered here today to join this man and this woman in holy matrimony. Who gives this woman in marriage? If you two voluntarily and freely enter into this marriage and know of no reason why you should not, you will indicate that as you have by joining right hand.
It's always been a mystery to me how two hearts can come together and love can last forever. But now that I have found you, I believe that a miracle has come when God sends a perfect one. Now gone are all my questions about. I've never been so sure of anything in my life. Oh, I wonder. what God was thinking when he created me. I wonder if he knew everything I would need, because he made all my dreams come true. When God made
Russell, do you take this woman to be your lawful wedded wife, and do you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses that you will love, honor, and cherish her in sickness and in health, and through adversity and prosperity, as long as you both shall live, so help you God. Amanda, do you take this man to be your lawful wedded husband? Do you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses that you will love, honor, and cherish him in sickness and in health, and through adversity and prosperity, as long as you both shall live, so help you God. The ring is an unending circle and has been used for centuries to symbolize the preeminence of marriage and relationship. Russell, will you take this ring that you have provided for Amanda and place it on her ring finger? Hold and repeat after me. With this ring, I, Russell, take thee, Amanda, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do we part. Amanda, will you take this ring that you have provided for Russell, place it on his ring finger, hold and repeat after me. With this ring, I, Amanda, take thee, Russell, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poor, in sickness, in health, to love and to cherish, till death do we part. In the book of Ruth, we read the appropriate words for this occasion. Entreat me not to leave you, nor to return from following you. For where you go, I will go, and where you lodge, I will lodge. Your people will be my people, and your God will be my God. Where you die, I will die, and there will I be buried. The Lord do so to me, and more also, if anything but death part thee and me. This time we're going to ask Brother Jimmy Fuller if he will come forward and lead us in a word of prayer.
Father God, we come to you today, Father, thanking you for this beautiful day that you've given us. Your beauty is all around us in your creation. We thank you for your love and your mercy. I pray for this couple, Heavenly Father. I pray, Heavenly Father, that you might bless Amanda like a daughter that I never had. We thank you for her, Lord. We thank you for Russell. Let him a few times, Father. I pray that you bless him. That he'll be a good husband, Heavenly Father, that he'll love Amanda like Christ did the church and gave himself for her. Father, I pray for Amanda that she'll love her husband. Father, honor him in all the days of her life. Father, we do thank you for your love and your mercy and your grace. I pray, Heavenly Father, that it might please you to bless them with material possessions as they had need. Father, give them a family if it's according to your will. Now, Father God, I thank you for Jesus, who loves us. And I especially thank you that you have joined this couple together. Now, Father, bless this couple. Thank you for all the folks that come out today. We pray in Jesus' name.
Now, having committed yourselves to each other in openness and in love, and having sealed your vows by the giving and receiving of a ring, and by the power vested in me as a minister of the gospel of Christ, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great honor and privilege to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Russell Hall.
Gotta get these chairs.
Get 30 of them.